It's October, so it's almost Halloween. Now, I'm not gonna say some stupid thing like, "Hey ghouls, it's a spooky season." If I ever say that ever, then you have my full permission to unsubscribe and spit on my face. Since it is the Halloween season, I thought it'd be appropriate to count down my top 10 favorite horror movies. Now, what's my take on most horror movies? They're goofy. Most of them. Very few of them are actually that effective to me. The Conjuring? Goofy. Insidious? Goofy. Friday the 13th? Goofy. Saw? Holy fuck, it's goofy. I can be fun sometimes, though. So here are my favorite horror movies. But first, my honorable mentions. And my honorable mentions are There Are None. Yeah, Eyes Without a Face is pretty insane. For a film as old as this, it really doesn't hold anything back in terms of disturbing imagery. A couple scenes that I won't spoil, for instance, had me squirming, and if you see the film, you'll know which scenes I'm talking about. Eyes Without a Face was way ahead of its time in that regard, even for 1959. I can't imagine how the general audience reacted to this film. It is truly an effective piece of artistic horror filmmaking that I feel has a lot to say about how we perceive outer beauty and how society feels like beauty very much matters. And the way it delivers that story feels like a dark, twisted poem of sorts. I genuinely think Get Out is one of the most creative films ever made. The way the camera essentially becomes a character in the film with the multiple subtle breaking of the fourth wall shots makes Get Out an emotionally intense film to experience. Jordan Peele actually won the Oscar for Best Original Screenplay for this movie, and in my opinion, it is more than just well deserved. In many ways, this could have just been a generic horror film, but Jordan Peele and lead actor Daniel Kaluuya find a way to make it so the audience knows that no one deserves this, no matter who they are. The way this film builds tension is also very creative. It puts you in a very awkward, uncomfortable situation that builds and builds until the payoff happens, and you're left feeling pretty disgusted by everything. And then the third act happens, which is one of the most satisfying third acts I've ever seen in the film. Get Out, I truly think, has so much to say about our society, and it is one of the most entertaining horror films that I've ever seen. This movie fucked me up when I saw it. The overall style and atmosphere of Hereditary is so bleak and slow and haunting and just masterful that right after watching it, I struggled to believe that this is Ari Aster's first feature film, which is insane to me because the attention to detail put into this movie, even the smallest things, blew my mind. He made sure that every detail in this movie was the most unsettling, bone-chilling thing you will ever see. He holds on to certain shots for an extended period of time to give you a sense of just this disturbing and gross atmosphere. And normally that would annoy me, but here it was terrifying. This is one of the most hopeless and unpredictable movies I've ever seen in my life. There isn't a single frame that might even hint to a thing of hope in this movie, and the way it's executed is absolutely terrifying. The way they portrayed mental health in this movie is absolutely unsettling. It does an amazing job putting you in the mindset of these characters. I was so invested in these characters and how the overall movie was executed that by the end of it, it actually gave me a panic attack the first time I saw it. I know fear is subjective and what might scare me might not scare you, but the thought of everything around you going absolutely nuts scares me. The slow yet noticeable process of being possessed by a demon scares me. Overall, evil in general scares me. I'm gonna get killed for having this one so low, but like, everything you heard about this is true. First off, this is one of the best edited movies I've ever seen. They know just when to cut, just when to keep the shot rolling, just when to keep everything silent. They give you the most terrifying experience, and usually I don't get scared by exorcism movies, but the way this was edited, directed, and performed was what made it terrifying. This entire film feels so miserable and hopeless, but these characters and the situation is so engaging to watch. It's something that needs to be seen to believe. While I do think it's a little bit goofy at times, there's no denying that this is a masterful piece of horror filmmaking. It might be weird having The Lighthouse on this list, but it is indeed a horror film, as well as many other things, and it's as awesome as everyone says it is. And I do believe that as a psychological horror film, it is very effective. Within the first 5 minutes of The Lighthouse, the way Robert Eggers sets up this world immediately sucked me in. The use of music, the ear-piercing sound design, the black and white claustrophobic cinematography sets up this really gross but weirdly satisfying atmosphere, and that kind of tone never lets up throughout the whole movie. Eggers has also shown to be a master of authenticity. It's clear how much work was put into this to actually make it feel like the late 1800s, even to accurately depict how people talk. I heard that he used journals from old lighthouse keepers to write the dialogue, and even if you don't like The Lighthouse, you gotta give some props to that kind of information. The Lighthouse is a movie that knows exactly what it is and isn't afraid to go fully insane. There are things that don't make any sense in this movie, and I think that's kind of the point. We're looking at the point of view of someone who's literally losing his mind, and the way this whole film is presented makes you feel like you're losing your mind with him. I haven't seen anything quite like this movie, so much that it's actually kind of hard to review. Guys, it's The Shining. Honestly, what can I say about The Shining that hasn't already been said? It's a masterpiece, and if you disagree, then get out of my house, because you're not worthy of Kubrick. Speaking of house...
Here's Johnny!
Yeah, and here I am, trying to take a shit in the privacy of my...
This is absolutely, without a doubt, the craziest movie I've ever seen in my life. You do not want any aspect of this movie spoiled for you at all if you choose to watch it. Let it just wash over you. Just know that this has the best use of tonal shift that I've ever seen in a movie. It switches tones and becomes a completely different, much darker movie out of nowhere, and it weirdly makes sense of how it gets there. It's one of the most stylistically pleasing movies I've ever seen, as even though the tone changes, the style never changes. It's coloring book type feel, and it adds so much to the insanity. It's the epitome of throw whatever on the wall and see what sticks, but it oddly works. I'm definitely gonna get hate for having this so high up on the list, but I don't care. This is probably the most entertaining horror movie that I've seen in years. The way David Robert Mitchell presents his story is so bizarre, but I couldn't look away. I love how it's literally supposed to feel like a dream. We never get a sense of where this takes place and what time period it is, because that's not important. What is important is what's happening on the surface, which is where the horror comes in. We don't know what these things are, and what they'll do if they catch you. So that to me made for an intense experience. But what I also love is that it also doesn't take itself seriously. This is a ridiculous concept, and David Robert Mitchell just has fun with it. I mean, look at the camera work here. I haven't seen cinematography that immersive for a horror film in a long time. Listen to this music. It's one of my favorite scores ever. Even the opening and final scenes immediately give you a sense of what you're in for. You get the idea. This film is the pure definition of pure horror movie fun for me. I can watch this anytime and never get bored. What makes the Texas Chainsaw Massacre so scary is the realism of it all. The film is shot like a whole movie, and there's rarely any music going along with it. All the kills are pretty quick, and for the most part, there isn't much build-up, and even though you don't see the aftermath, you know these characters got killed in the most gruesome way, and it makes you feel gross. That's what makes it disturbing. The constant screaming combined with the chainsaw sound effects makes this so raw and gritty, and they really don't hold anything back here. Within the whole film, you get this helpless vibe with these characters, especially when you add in the fact that these murders are happening one by one with the other characters not knowing about it. The Texas Chainsaw Massacre works because it understands that real terror comes from lack of awareness and control, because we're never more vulnerable when we're unprepared with what may happen. Imagine being all alone with people you don't know or trust, and this presence that you can't describe starts wreaking havoc in the area, taking the form of someone who looks normal, but really they're not, all the while taking place in the middle of nowhere. That thought terrifies me, and The Thing takes this concept and brings it to the extreme. I am obsessed with this movie. It holds nothing back and throws you into this insanity, and you're left having no idea what's going to happen, but you need to act fast. There are so many unanswered questions here, like, are the aliens only in the Arctic or are they all over the world? How can you immediately know if an alien took the form of another human? How many are around? And that's what makes this so terrifying. Knowing there is a presence somewhere, not knowing where it is, not having any of the answers, but you have to act quick in order to save yourself and others. Not only that, but also not knowing who to trust and not being able to call for help. And thankfully, in this film, we have characters who make smart decisions and try their best to fight back, but even then, during the film, we don't know how effective their strategies will be until a payoff happens. There are moments when their weapons fail, and they have to act quick. Let's also get another obvious out of the way. These are the best practical effects that I've ever seen. Like, how do you even describe stuff like what's in this movie? How do you even create it? How do you make it feel so real? The Thing is a masterpiece in many regards. But at the top of it all, it's a masterpiece in tension. It pulls you into the situation, slams its foot all the way on the gas, and doesn't let you go. And for that, not only is The Thing my favorite horror movie of all time, it's one of my all-time favorite movies in general. And that's it, bye-bye.